be without a joke. Now, Elder Gooding is not only a great preacher and a great pastor, but he's also a great family man. And I found out why this is true. Some years ago, he and Sister Gooding took a trip to the Grand Canyon. And they wanted to explore the Grand Canyon on horseback. So they got the horses, and everything was going smooth. And all of a sudden, the horse that Sister Gooding was on started bucking and jumping. Finally quieted down, and she said out loud, "That's one." Went on down about a mile later, old horse started acting up again. She almost fell off. And when they got the horse quiet, she said, "That's two." Went on up the road a little bit. This time the horse just did it. And Sister Gooding fell off the horse. She said, "That's three." And she reached in her pocketbook, pulled out a gun, and shot the horse dead. And Elder Gooding looked at her, his eyes wide open. "Honey, you shot the horse." She said, "That's one." I'm gonna quit while I'm ahead.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I guess I'm gonna have to hold on my phone today. How's everyone doing?
Good. Marvelous.
Beautiful evening. Everybody got their clothes on and everything. We smiling. Are we eating good?
Yeah.
And everyone hear me over in the corner?
Yeah.
We're here for unity, y'all. I mean, we need our peace and our correct.
That's right.
Everybody want peace, right?
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna just take a moment of your time. In these days of havoc and misinformation, we still need to be free and to have our peace. For within our conscious hearts, we can find more than just a little loving for one another. And with our patience and sincere gratitude, we are beginning to see a glimpse of hope for the changing dynamics of the Bronxboro landscape. And regardless of the propaganda and the poisons distributed throughout the population, we cannot bow down to the evils and give up the battle we are fighting for our babies. We've even started to see unity in the midst of our grief and young souls who now are eternally sleeping. I'm sure all of us want the same thing. We want love, we deserve our peace, and we strive for our harmony. I know the police department is more than willing to give a helping hand, and I'm sure the surrounding communities are working diligently to see a brighter day. It's clear we're not just here for ourselves, but our children and our grandchildren for obvious reasons. I've seen many of you here before, and we understand the cost of a life and the consequences to an unseen tragedy. But before we sit back and allow these situations to continue to affect our families and our New York City love, we're going to have to commit to more than just a meeting of minds, but a meeting of specifics and a meeting of deliverance. You see, we find ourselves with the opportunity to win if we just pay attention to the children, because in the home is where it begins. If the penalties of my survival means helping someone else, why not make myself available and teach them to do for themselves? Yes, there are problems, but we don't have to fail. I know we're worth it. And if we've decided together that we're not going to take it anymore, then it's time we stop the problems and begin to heal our New York City from its core. Know this, there are no wasted algorithms. And with us here right now, we're witnessing this covenant to build on for the good of the people and not the death of the people. For in this room, we're taking a stand. We need to take the lead and proceed to bring our peace back for every child, woman, and man. And make no mistake, it's a beautiful life. So let's live it together and receive our blessings as one. Thank you for the love.